Hola.
Hola.
Bienvenidos a Lightspeed Spanish.
Bienvenidos.
Well, today we have a test for you. This is a test for beginners. Mm-hmm. And the first test, there are two, there's one coming next week. The first test is a multiple choice.
Yes.
Un poco más fácil.
Sí, un poco más fácil.
Un poco más fácil.
Y la semana que viene, uno de traducir.
Un poco más difícil.
Un poco más difícil.
So, get yourself prepared. The questions will come up on the screen, so you just need to choose the right one. Y vamos a ver, there are 10.
Extra points if they can answer straight away without having to wait for options.
Absolutely.
That would be an extra point for you.
I'll leave a little gap so you can just shout it out. Shout it out. Vale, pues empezamos y hablamos de todo en la segunda parte.
Bien, pues empezamos el test de esta semana para beginners, ¿no?
Beginners.
Mm-hmm. Pregunta número uno. I don't know this man. A. No sé este hombre. B. No conozco este hombre. C. No conozco a este hombre.
So which one are you going to choose? So I'm going to choose no conozco a este hombre.
Eso es, muy bien.
The A, the personal A, when you're talking about knowing somebody or any interaction with people, you need that A for a bit of respect.
Eso es, muy bien. Vale, pregunta número dos. There's time. A. Es tiempo. B. Hay tiempo. C. Está tiempo.
Ser, estar, haber. So I'm going to say, hay tiempo.
B, muy bien. Hay tiempo.
Hay tiempo. When you hear there with is, you know you're with haber.
Or with are.
Oh,
there,
yeah.
There is, there are.
The verb to be with there, then you're with haber.
Eso es, yeah? Muy bien. Unless we say, it's there.
Ah.
Then it's the pointing.
That's
one.
That's different
it's
if you're talking about location.
Vale, número 3. There are two cats on the chair.
The classic sentence from any
there
language
are two cats
learning method.
On the chair. A. Son dos gatos en la silla. B. Hay dos gatos en la silla. C. Son dos gatos en la mesa.
Okay, so I'm going to go for hay dos gatos en la silla.
Muy bien, B, ¿no? La opción B. Mm-hmm. Muy bien, Gordon, vale. Número 4. Are you coming with me? A. ¿Vienes conmé? B. ¿Vienes con mí? C. ¿Vienes conmigo?
So I'm going for C. Vienes conmigo. All of the with the con is one of the prepositions that needs to have amigo, yeah?
Conmigo.
Conmigo.
Contigo.
Consigo.
Uh-huh. With himself, herself, uh-huh. Itself. Itself. Y luego el resto con
no.
Él, con ella, con nosotros.
But we don't say sinmigo. Okay?
No.
Sin mí.
Solo conmigo.
Conmigo.
Eso es. Muy bien. Número 5. He tells me it.
Ooh.
Okay, he tells me it. A. Me lo dice. B. Lo me dice. C. Dímelo.
Mm. So I'm going to go for me lo dice.
Me lo dice. Eso
me
es.
Lo dice. How okay. Did you do? If you have problems with the order of the pronouns, have a look on our website and search out the PRID rule. Okay, P-R-I-D, and it shows you the order that they have to come in. And what's wrong with dímelo?
Dímelo is the command. That means tell me. Hmm. Command. Tell me it. Yeah, tell me
tell it. Tell me it.
Mm-hmm. But the sentence is, he tells me it, so it's not a command. Muy bien. Número 6. The small red house is mine.
Ooh.
A. La pequeña casa roja es mía. B. La casa pequeña y roja es mía. C. Las dos son correctas.
Interesting. So we've got la pequeña casa roja es mía.
He could look at it because the answers are not here.
They're not there.
There, so yeah. He's just reading.
O la casa pequeña y roja es mía. I would say both of them are okay.
Eso es. Entonces, la correcta es C. Las dos son correctas.
Okay. So what's the difference, so la pequeña casa roja and la casa pequeña y roja?
You can put, for emphasis, or if one of them is more important, you can move it before the noun.
Yeah.
Okay, but we tend to use this in set scenarios. It's not constant.
Sure.
Okay, but we can, if one stands out, we can move it before the noun. So it stands out, the pequeña casa, so that's more important
more
than
important
red.
More important than the color.
Okay.
Yeah, yeah.
Usually with pequeña, gran, we tend to move those before sometimes, okay?
Yeah.
But sometimes we just move it before for emphasis.
And remember that...
Because it's not the natural place. Place is afterwards.
Afterwards. And remember that in Spanish, unlike in English, there isn't any order of descriptive words.
No.
In English, we have a very fixed order, up to 14 places, I believe, which we don't know about until we say it and we say, oh, that sounds wrong. In Spanish, there's no order.
Yes. In Spanish, we could say the red small house, the small red house.
Yeah.
But if you put them in a row after the noun, which is the natural position, then you would have to put an and before the last one.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So 1, 2 and the third one, for example, or 1 and 2. Mm-hmm. Yeah. So both could be correct. Muy bien. Número 7. It's good. It's good.
It's good.
For the greater good. It's good. A. Es bueno. B. Está bueno. C. Es bien.
Okay. So, in this sentence without context, we're going to say A. Es bueno.
Okay.
Yeah.
By elimination, it can't be C. It can't be es bien, because that's incorrect. With bien, we're only going to use estar.
Exactly. Ser bien doesn't exist in Spanish. The verb ser with bien doesn't exist.
Now, but with bueno, usually, most of the times, we use the verb ser. Ser bueno,
mm-hmm.
Ser malo. Yeah. But sometimes we can use the verb estar with bueno. Yeah.
Very true. Yeah, but only in a specific context.
When
context,
it
yeah.
means something is tasty, and está bueno, and a person is tasty as well.
Sexy.
Yeah, but that's in Spain, because in Latin America they use estar bueno for other things, so those rules vary a little bit. But without context, we would go for A es bueno. See, in this one.
Mm-hmm.
Número 8. I'm okay.
Okay.
I'm okay. A. Estoy vale. B. Soy bien. C. Estoy bien.
Okay. So by elimination, the same. Soy bien doesn't exist and can't exist. The verb said with bien, not. So we've got, let me see.
Estoy vale.
Estoy vale.
A o C, estoy bien.
Estoy bien. So it has to be estoy bien.
Estoy bien.
Vale is used in the way that they use okay.
That's like an agreement. Like,
yeah.
Okay, agreed, vale.
Yes. Yeah.
Yeah.
That suggestion
kind of okay.
is worth considering.
Yes.
Yeah, that kind of vale, yeah.
Yeah, like when I said to Gordon, do you want to go out and spend lots of money in Zara, and he says, okay.
Ni hablar.
Vale, that would be vale. Okay, but we would never say estoy vale, because that doesn't mean anything.
And that sentence reminds me of Greg from Canada. Yeah. And Greg, he's a Canadian, but his mum is English. And of course, the Canadians, just like the Americans, they will, if somebody says to you, how are you? And they say, I'm good.
I'm good.
And his mum, he said, he used, in the lessons, he used to say, my mum would say to me, I know you're good, but are you well?
Yeah. Yes, it's true that in the US and Canada, they say, I'm good.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. But bien in this sentence translates as well. I'm well.
I'm fine.
Yeah, I'm, like, fine. I'm fine. I'm okay. I'm well. Yeah.
Número nueve. I always arrive on time. A. Siempre llego en tiempo. B. Siempre llego a tiempo. C. Siempre llego a hora.
This is one of those ones with a preposition, a verb with a preposition. And either you know it or you don't know it.
And time.
And time.
Because time could be...
Sure. So I'm going to go for siempre llego a tiempo.
Muy bien. Opción B, siempre llego a tiempo. Eso es.
It's always llegar a.
Llegar a.
And obviously time in this context is not hora, which is the time, the current time, but time generally.
Muy bien. Muy bien. Y la última, número 10. She's a bad person. She's a bad person. A. Es una mala persona. B. Es una persona mala. C. Las dos son correctas.
Mm. So what do you think? So I would say C. I think both of them are correct.
Bien. Las dos son correctas. So again, with pequeño, gran, grande, buen, bueno, buena, malo, etc., mala, we tend to move those more than the average
to give it a bit of emphasis
before the noun. So it's very common to hear una mala persona or una buena persona, a good person or a bad person, literally.
Yeah, and be careful with the word malo. If you want to say he's a bad man and you put malo before the man, you've got to take the O off.
Yes, we have a video on this.
Yeah.
On gran, grande, mal, mala, malo.
Mal hombre.
Mm-hmm. And then B is also possible. Es una persona mala. That would be the natural position of the adjective, so...
Yeah.
That would be fine. See?
So how did you do? Thank you for that, Cynthia.
De nada.
How did you do? Did you get 7 out of 10, 8 out of 10, 9 out of 10, 10 out of 10? Or if you didn't, or the ones that you didn't get right, they're the ones that you probably need to look at and start doing a little bit of study. However, good news. If you go to our website and you go into the search bar, you can search any of those topics and we've got videos all
That's
over
true.
The place. Or you can look in YouTube and we've got, I think, 1,400 videos in YouTube. So we've covered these subjects many times, okay? So you can find out everything you need.
And if you like the tests and our content, please hit the like button because we really like that.
Mm-hmm. Pues, muchas gracias, Cynthia.
A ti.
Y eso es todo. Ahora nos vamos.
Y nos vemos.
Hasta luego. Adiós.